All right, in this lesson, we're going to be looking at linear and nonlinear functions, and specifically how to tell if you have a linear function on your hands and what they look like. So, the key root of the word linear here, you can see, is line. Right? So, when we're dealing with linear functions, we're dealing with functions that can be graphed and basically look in the same form as a line. We've done a lot of graphing lines before, so hopefully these things will seem familiar. Linear functions, three different ways they can be represented. If we can write the equation in the form y equal to mx plus b. This is our slope-intercept form, you might remember from before. I prefer to write it in this form, just because it's easy to draw a graph from it. You have the slope, and you have the y-intercept right there. So if you can rearrange the equation of a linear of a function to get it to be that format, we have a linear function. So let's say, see if these are linear. Let's do a couple examples. 3x minus 4. Y equal to 3x minus 4. Is this a linear function? Well, it's already in that format. We have y equal to some number times x, our slope, plus our y-intercept. And here is negative 4. Same thing as adding negative 4. So we've got that one there. What about 2x plus y equal to 6? Well, it's not in this format, but can we convert it? Yeah, we can. We can solve for the y here if we subtract 2x from each side. We can change that into y is equal to negative 2x plus 6. Same format. Good. So these are both linear functions. How about 3x equal to 2y? Again, it's not in that format, but if we divide both sides by 2, those things divide out, and we get y is equal to 3 halves x. Here, our plus b is actually plus 0. It's not really there. Our b value is 0, so our y-intercept is 0. So it is in that format. Something that are not in that format, let's look at what y is equal to x squared. Right. Here, we have a power of x higher than 1. All of these have a single power of x in them. Here, we have x squared. Because that's squared, this is not a linear function. If we graph it, we would find that it's not a graph of a line. How about x times y is equal to 10? Well, if we were to rearrange this for y, we'd have to divide both sides by x, and we get y is equal to 10 over x. That x in the denominator down here, that is bad. We can't have that. And x in the denominator makes the graph definitely not a line. So the x has to be in the numerator, has to be multiplied by a single number there, the slope. So because the x is in the denominator here, also doesn't work. And the last one we're going to look at here, how about y is equal to the square root of x plus a number. Again, x under a square root, not the same as x by itself. This isn't a single power of x. This is, if you remember back to our exponents unit, this is the same as x to the 1/2 plus 3. So we don't have that single power. Not good. Right. So those are not linear functions. So if you can write the equation of the function in the form y equals mx plus b, it is linear. Another way we can tell if we have a linear function, if the graph is a straight line. Let's draw some graphs, see what those look like. So, I grab my ruler, let's draw a line something like this. Here we have a straight line. We can find the equation of this. It would be y equal to 2x plus 0. No y-intercept is 0. So we can already see that we have a straight line, which means it's linear. And if we look at the equation of that, it's also in that format. So these two concepts are kind of related. What else could we have here? Let's draw one that's not. How about, why don't we draw this guy right here. This is actually a very crudely drawn parabola. The equation of this is from our y equal to x squared we had before. We can see that this is not a straight line because it obviously curves, goes down, back up again. So this is not a linear function. This one is. And last but not least, the third way we can represent a linear function is the graph of it is a series of points. that lie along a straight line. So, series of points that lie along a straight line. What would that look like? Well, let's draw one that is a linear function. If we had something like this, here, all of these points seem to lie along a straight line. If we did connect the dots, we're not going to, because sometimes a function only needs algebra certain inputs, we would see that they do lie along a straight line, so this one is linear. What's one that's not linear look like? Well, we could have a series of points, something like that. And we see if we were to put a straight line along those, they're not all on a straight line. And there's no way to connect all those dots with a single straight line. So this one is a non-linear function. So three conditions for having a linear function. We can write the equation in that form, y equals mx plus b. We can graph it as a straight line, or we can graph it as a series of points that lie along a straight line. If none of those three conditions are filled, it is not a linear function, so we call it a non-linear function. And those we get into in higher level math classes.